Rama Rao's niece, a pretty girl of 11, had come to stay with him. She was from a big town. She knew how to play the veena and the harmonium. She also had a sweet voice. Both her parents had died and her uncle had brought her home. Ranga was just the boy for her and she the more suitable bride for him. Right, so the narrator is decided that he's going to get her married with Rama Rao's niece. She's a young girl of 11, both her parents have passed away and she's staying with her uncle. Since I was a frequent visitor to Rama Rao's place, the girl was quite free with me. I completely forgot to mention her name. Ratna it was. The very next morning, I went to their house and told Rama Rao's wife, I'll send you some buttermilk. Ask Ratna to fetch it. Since I was a frequent visitor to Rama Rao's place, the girl was quite free with me. Sit down, both of you. I completely forgot to mention her name. Ratna it was. The very next morning, I went to the house and told Rama Rao's wife, I've sent some buttermilk for you. Ask Ratna to fetch it. Ratna came. It was a Friday, so she was wearing a grand sari. I told her to sit in my room and requested her to sing a song. I sent for Ranga. While she was singing the song, Krishnamurti in front of my eyes, class, silence. Ranga reached the door. He stopped at the threshold. What's the threshold? The entrance, right? He did not want the singing to stop, but was curious to see the singer. Carefully, he peeped in. The light coming into the room was blocked. Ratna looked up and seeing a stranger there, abruptly stopped. Now the narrator is a very clever person and he has kind of, you know, like arranged that Ranga should see this girl. And he's asked her also to fetch buttermilk. He's called Ranga there also. And it was a Friday, a special day, some, you know, like occasion. And Ratna was singing, right? And at that time, who went there? Ranga. And he heard the singing, but he could not see the singer. Suppose you buy the best quality mango, you eat it slowly, severing its peel before biting it into the juicy flesh. You do not want to waste any part of it before you take another bite. The fruit slips out of your hand and falls to the ground. How do you feel? Ranga's face showed the same disappointment when the singing stopped. So like he wanted the singing to continue and he wanted to see the person who was singing, but the girl quite shy and she immediately stopped and she saw a stranger. You sent for me? He asked as he came in and sat on a chair. Ratna stood at a distance, her head lowered. Ranga repeatedly glanced at her. Once our eyes met and he looked very embarrassed. No one spoke for a long while. It was my coming in that stopped the singing. Let me leave, right? Because I came, so the girl stopped singing. So let me leave. Words, mere words. The fellow said he would leave, but did not make a move. How can one expect words to match actions in these days of Kaliyug? So see, the boy was saying he's leaving, but he's not moving from there. He wanted to hear her sing. Ratna ran inside, overcome by shyness. After a while, Ranga asked, who is that girl, Swami? Who's that inside? The lion wanted to know. The he-goat who had taken shelter in the temple replied, "Does it matter who I am? I'm a poor animal who has already eaten 9 lions. I have vowed to eat one more. Tell me, are you male or female?" The lion fled the place in fear, it seems. Like the he-goat, I said, "What does it matter to either of us who she is? I'm already married and you aren't the marrying kind. So it could be anyone, right? You don't want to get married soon and I'm already married, right?" Very hopefully I asked, "She isn't married then?" His voice did not betray his excitement, but I knew it was there. "She was married a year ago." His face shriveled like a roasted brinjal. After a while, Ranga left saying, "I must go. I have work at home." So yes, so the narrator has lied to him that the girl is married, right? I went to our Shastri the next morning and told him, "Keep everything ready to read the stars. I'll come later." I tutored him in all that I wanted him to say. So now what has the narrator done? He's gone to the Shastri. Who's the Shastri? The astrologer. What does an astrologer do? Yes, yes, correct. Yes, Raghu, stand up. What does an astrologer do? What? Is that an answer? What is your answer? What's your answer? Tell me what an astrologer does. Yes, Krish. Yes, Krish, tell me. Apart from that, what else does the astrologer do? Yes, Harshika? What is astrology? Yes? How is astronomy different from astrology? Oh, yes. Yes, Krish? Stars. And in astronomy, sit down. Raghav, you better start paying attention to your studies, and I will convey this information in the parents' group today. Right? Sit down. Astrology, yes, it is. Both of them are there about, about the planets, the stars. But when you talk about astrology here, it is very, you talk about the planetary positions. And astrologer, what does he do? Like about the planetary positions at the time of birth. And that is how they tell about your future and about your marriage prospects and things like that. Isn't it right? Astronomy is also, yes, it's the study of the stars, the planets. Astrology is also a recognized science. Okay? It is not that, yes, anybody can just do that, right? So astrology is also science. And here, please here, listen now. Silence. So when we do, read about astrology, so you might be looking at the newspaper, we read about a zodiac sign, which is according to our birth, according to our name also we have, right? So those zodiac signs are there, and we love to read what is written in the newspaper, right? And we read it whether it is going to come true or not. So favorite color, number, everything is mentioned along with that. Yes, you read it once a while or every day? Whenever you get time, yes, so once a while. But there are some people, yes, silence please, who really follow astrology. Yes, Simran, you want to say something? So we all have our own opinion, right? Yes, there is one thing that according to astrology, when you read about the zodiac signs and things like that, then we feel that we categorize people into these 12 kinds of, right? Signs only. But the difference lies in the planetary position at that particular time and date. So that is what makes us different. You might be of the same zodiac sign, but your qualities might be a little different, isn't it? Right? It's very interesting also to read about that. Yes, it's good to keep yourselves busy also. Now here, what has the narrator done? He's gone to meet the Shastri, right? And the Shastri is the person who does all this astrology, right? And you do talk to your parents, many of you might have your, ready at birth. Yes? Yeah. Those of us who believe in it, many don't. So he's gone to the astrologer and he has also told him what he has to say. What are the things that the astrologer used to make those predictions? One of the things he uses? Yes? Yeah, so there's a chart, it shows the planetary position. What is? Do you think he uses? All that he does. Yes. How much of it do you think is true? It's 100% true? Is it? Okay. Now, let's see. Yes, boys. Bring that notebook here. Tishnu, show me what notes you're taking. I found no change in Ranga when I met him. Yes, please. Let's read this part. This is the most interesting part of the story. Come on, look at it. Ramneek, look at your book. Where's your book? I found no change in Ranga when I met him that afternoon. What's the matter? You seem to be lost in thought, I said. Nothing's wrong with me. Believe me. Headache? Come, let's go and see a doctor. I have no headache. I am my usual self. I went through the same thing when the process of choosing a girl for me was going on. But I don't think so that could be a reason for your present condition. See, the narrator is very adamant. For everything he talks about is one only reason, right? That as if marriage is going to solve all the problems in his life. He said, yeah, even I, Harsimar, please keep quiet. Ranga stared at me. Come, let's go and see Shastri. So the Shastri is going to cure your headache. He's going to find out that what is the reason why you're upset. I suggested we will find out whether Guru and Shani are favorable for you or not. So yeah, these planets, they cause a lot of problems, isn't it? So Shani creates a lot of problems for... Ranga accompanied me without any protest. As soon as Shastri saw me, he exclaimed, "What a surprise, Shama. Haven't seen you for a long time." And the surprising thing is that the narrator had met Shastri in the morning and he's pretending as if they're meeting after a very long time. Okay? Yes. Shama is none other than your servant, the narrator of this tale. Now we know the narrator's name. What's his name? Shama. Shyam or Shyama, right? I got angry and shouted. What? Only this morning. Shastri completed my sentence. You finished all your work and are now free to visit me. He would have spilled the beans at that time, but the Shastri stopped him. Had he not done so, I would have ruined our plan by bursting like grains that are kept in the sun to dry. I was extremely careful of what I said afterwards. So he was going to spoil the whole plan. Shastri turned to Ranga. When did the young son of our accountant clerk come home? What can I do for him? It's very rarely that he visits us. Take out your paraphernalia. Our Rangappa seems to have something on his mind. Can you tell us what's worrying him? Shall we put your science of astrology to the test? So there's something wrong with Rangappa. So use your astrology. Find out what it is. And sometimes even to ask about our future, right? And you're going through a bad phase. You feel like, yes, let's talk to an astrologer. Okay? If you really believe in that. Once again, I'm just saying here, it is not something that everybody does. Shastri turned to Ranga. When did the young... Sorry, I've read this. There was authority in my voice as I spoke to Shastri. He took out two sheets of paper, some cowries, and a book of Palmyra leaves. Ours is an ancient science, Aya. There's a story to it, but I won't tell you that story now. This is not a Harikatha which allows you to tell a story within a story. Gurkirat, Harsimran, sit straight and look at your books. Shastri moved his lips as fast as he counted on his fingers and then asked, what's your star? Okay, you may get bored. I'll tell it to you some other time. So a story within a story, then what is astrology? How it started to be used. Cowries to shells, yeah, the white shells which they use. What's your star? Ranga didn't know. Never mind. Shastri indicated with a shake of his head. He did some more calculations before saying in a serious tone, it's about a girl. Do you think he was telling the truth or he was lying? He was lying because everything had been planned beforehand between Shastri and the narrator, Shyam. I had been controlling my laughter all this while, but now I burst out laughing. I turned to Ranga, exactly what I had said. Who is the girl? It was your humble servant who asked the question. The narrator asked the question, who is the girl? Shastri thought for a while before replying. She probably has the name of something found in the ocean. Kamal. Maybe Kamala is found in the ocean. Kamal hoga na? Yeah. Could it be Pachi moss? Must it be moss if it's not Kamala? Why not pearl or ratna? Precious stone. Ratna means precious stone. Like, yeah, you have oysters and all pearls which are found from the, yes. Ratna, the girl in Rama Rao's house is Ratna. Tell me, is there any chance of our negotiations bearing fruit? Definitely, he said after thinking for some time. Yes? What? So he's saying that the person who is there or who's worried, he's worried about or thinking about is... The name, it is similar to something that comes from the ocean. So they're making guesses, wild guesses, and they know who the name is, right? So Kamal and Moss, and then they say Ratna. And who was Ratna? What was the name of the girl who was singing? Ratna, right? And matter what had the narrator told about her. Was she married or not? He said, yes, she was married. Right? But now he's saying, let's see if our negotiations can bear fruit. Can something come out of these calculations? Definitely, he said, after thinking for some time, there was surprise on Ranga's face and some happiness. I noticed it. But that girl is married, I said. Then I turned to him, his face had fallen. So Ranga was a little happy. But then when he was reminded that the girl is married, he became a little upset. I don't know all that. There may be some other girl who is suitable. I only told you what a Shastra indicated, Shastri said. So I've just told you, yeah, this is the name of the girl. I don't know whether she's married or not. I've just given you the reason. We left the place. On the way, we passed by Rama Rao's house. Ratna was standing at the door. I went in alone and came out a minute later. Surprising, the girl isn't married, it seems. Someone told me the other day that she was. What Shastri told us has turned out to be true after all. But Rangappa, I can't believe that you have been thinking of her. Sway on the name of Madhavacharya and tell me, is it true what Shastri said? So what did the narrator do? When they were going back home, they passed by Rama Rao's house. They saw Ratna standing outside. And the narrator, he just pretended to go inside and ask maybe questions and all. And he had lied in the beginning only. And he is coming out and telling him that, see, like, of course, she's not married. We thought that she was. And now he wants Ranga to tell about his mind. What are the thoughts which are going on, right? So what is it? Is it true what Shastri said? That have you been thinking about Ratna? I do not know whether anyone else would have been direct. Ranga admitted, there's a greater truth in that Shastra than we imagine. What he said is absolutely true. And poor thing, he doesn't know that he's being fooled, right? Nothing what that Shastra said was true. It had all been pre-planned. Okay, Shastri was at the well when I went there that evening. I said, so Shastri Gale, you repeated everything I had taught you without giving rise to any suspicion. What a marvelous Shastra yours is. He didn't like it at all. What are you saying? What you said to me was what I could have found out myself from the Shastras. Don't forget, I developed on the hints you had given me. Tell me, is this what a decent man says? Yes, so what about astrology here, right here? What about the method here that they have used for Ranga to admit that there is, you know, or that...